I know five mothers that lost their children to suicide because of bullying. And I'm just one person, and I know five. So how many do you know, or you, or you? I wonder if we can't do better. Does it have to be this way? Imagine a world, a school, or just a classroom with no bullying. Is it possible? There are many that say no, it's not possible. But I say yes, it is possible. Bullying is not a law of nature like gravity. It can be prevented. And I'm going to prove it to you. I'm going to prove it to you. I'm sure that you are all a part of at least one group with no bullying. Think about it. Am I a part of one bully-free, at least, one bully-free group? Raise your hand if you are. Just look at this. So, if all these groups are free of bullying, then all the groups in the world can be, one classroom at a time. The first step is bullying prevention. And if we want to prevent bullying, it is important to look at it not only as the problem of the individuals directly involved, as we have done pretty much through the times, that it's the problem of the children that are bullied or the children that bully. But let's look at it as a social problem of the whole group, connected to peer relationships, power, popularity, norms, and culture. And if we believe that, then bullying intervention and bullying prevention has to be aimed not only at the individuals, but also at the group as a whole. And let me tell you one story about how only working with the individuals might not always work. Last August, I met a teacher. She is teaching young children here in Iceland. And she told me about a boy in her class that has no friends. This boy started the school year by being mean to the other kids. He was hurting them. And what sometimes happens in these cases, these children, they get a bad reputation amongst their classmates and even their parents. And soon there are norms in this class and in this group of people that say, let's leave him alone, let's not play with him. And what happened was that's exactly what happened. He was all alone and nobody wanted to play with him. So what is the solution to this? What should we do? And of course, we have to help him with this negative behavior. And the teacher, she did just that. She helped him stop being mean. And at the end of the year, he stopped. He was not mean to anybody. But in January, February, March, April, all the way to August, nobody had played with him. He was all alone, isolated, and without friends. So he asked around, do you want to play with me? No, the children said. Do you want to play with me? No. Each rejection has an arrow to the heart. So what did we do wrong here? We fixed the child. But what we did not fix was the whole group. Fighting against bullying has been in my heart for a long time. And when I hear stories like this one about children with no friends and isolated and rejected by peers, yes, I easily get tears in my eyes. And I could talk about this the whole day. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to focus on one solution, one project called Kids with Kids. 2 years ago, I made a handbook about bullying prevention with a woman called Hrefna Sigurjónsdóttir. She is the CEO of the Home and School Association here in Iceland. And after we had made the book, she got some money to introduce the content of the book to parents and students. And the idea was that Salka Sól, which is a famous actress and singer here in Iceland, she would meet with children, 10 to 12 year olds, and tell them her story about bullying. And then in the evening, me, Salka, and Hrefna, we would meet with the parents. Does it sound great? Famous person telling a great story? No. It sounds great. And of course, she can influence some of the children. But if the norms in the group say that it's allowed to be mean to a person or it's allowed to exclude someone, the children will most likely follow these rules, these social rules, even though they no, it's not right. And let's not condemn the children for this, because we as grown-ups, we do the same thing. We also follow social rules. So a 45 minutes talk from a famous person, even though she is a great one, is probably not enough. So last year, on my way to the meeting, when we were going to plan this talk, I'm walking up the stairs to Heimilens Skole Association, and I start to think to myself, what are you doing? This is not going to help anything. This is not going to change anything. And we are wasting our time. And as I was walking, I got another idea, and a much better idea. We should do it in a different way. We should involve the children. We should use positive leadership and peer education. And we should do it for a longer time, because 45 minutes is not enough to change culture. And what you can learn from this story is that you should all walk upstairs. Great things that can happen. So I went into the meeting and I told them about this, and they liked it, and so we changed the whole thing. And what we did instead was that we cooperated with 5 schools here in Iceland last spring. We invited teenagers from the 9th grade. And here in Iceland, when you are in grade 9, it means you are 14 to 15 years old. And we invited them to be a part of the project. In the beginning, we went and we talked to the teachers, the school counselors, and some department heads, and we told them about the project, and we prepared them for their roles, and then we just started. We were one day in each school, started with Salka. She told them her story, and they were really listening to her. You could see that this was having an impact on them. They had great questions afterwards. And should we have stopped then? No. Remember, this is not enough. We have to do more than this. So Salka left, and I took over. And I had the teenagers for 3 hours. They got ready-made lessons plans, and I trained them in how to implement these lessons with younger students. I got help from the teachers and the staff, and then we had 3 very intensive training hours. What is very important in this project is that all the students participated in the training, and all the students could decide themselves if they wanted to participate or not, if they wanted to become peer educators. We encouraged them, and great many said, yes, I want to do this. Actually, it was 80 to 100% in 4 out of 5 schools, so they really wanted to do this, and they surprised their teachers. The teachers told us afterwards, they were like, wow, you know, that because they were much greater number of participants than the teachers had thought beforehand. Great many participated, which was really, really great. And then I left, and the teachers took over, and they prepared the 9th graders. They divided them into smaller groups, and each group got assigned 1 class of younger children. And then they had some, maybe 2 or 3 weeks to prepare, because this is a hard thing to do, to have 3 times 80 minutes. For a 10-year-old when you were 15. But then they implemented the whole thing. And between each session, they could revise, they could change the program, and they, even though these were ready-made lesson plans, they could also include their own stories and their perspectives. And this really, really went great. So what is it that we could learn from this? Actually, a lot. And I want to underline 3 things. First, the participation. Often when we want kids and teenagers to do stuff like this, we handpick them. And who do we pick? We pick the same kids again and again and again. We pick the outgoing, the smart, the great kids. And they get all the opportunities and all the training. But we leave out a big, big group that do not get the opportunity and do not get the training. So a big part of this project is that all get the training and all get the opportunity to participate. And as I told you before, the number were much higher than the teacher had thought beforehand. So they were up, all the way up to 100% of participation in the 9th grade. That is one thing. 2, these ninth graders are now in grade 10, which is the last grade in compulsory school in Iceland. And they come into the 10th grade with this experience as positive leaders, and hopefully this will positively influence the school climate this year. And thirdly, I want to talk about the 10 to 12 year old that got to spend 3 times 80 minutes with 15 year old from their old school. They now know more about bullying, they know more about friendship and peer relationships and how to be a great classmate, and they heard it from a 15 year old. And let's just face it, grown-ups, they will listen more to them than what they do with us. And finally, one part of the whole thing is that the ninth graders, one of the things that they did was that they gave thumbs up or thumbs down when they met with their class, some kids from their class, in the corridors or in the food court or out in the schoolyard, and maybe somebody was teasing someone, then the ninth grader intervened and they did like this. Or maybe someone was helping somebody and then they did like this. So now this year, these 4th, 5th and 6th graders, they know somebody in grade 10, they know some of the kids personally, which is great, because sometimes when you are 10 you are a little bit scared of the scary teenagers, but they know them. And also, if they are misbehaving in the corridors, they might get a thumbs down. So it went really well, and we are starting with 5 new schools soon and hopefully more schools after that. This is not the only way, of course, not the only way to prevent bullying, but it is one way. And it has to do with components that I really believe in, which is peer education and positive leadership. It is also very easy to use, and it's sustainable and simple, and the teacher now can use it in the school year after year. To prevent bullying is saving a life, both in terms of life quality, happiness and health, but we could also be literally be saving a life. As a mother myself, I often think about these 5 mothers I talked about in the beginning, and I really hope that these are the 5 last mothers to have this terrible, horrific experience. And I think if all of us, if we like open our hearts a little bit and we decide in our heart, can you decide with me, in your hearts, that we will do everything we can to fight against bullying, then we are on the way to a bully-free world. Thank you.